physical attraction to someone else is something most of us have experienced before and is a big part of an intimate relationship. But have you ever wondered what makes a certain individual more attractive in the first place? The answer to this comes down to evolution and natural selection, because not all humans used to survive back when we were hunting mammoths. We adapted a way to see some individuals as more attractive, based on the fact that these individuals will lead to us or our offspring surviving better. Certain traits that were criteria for assessing whether an individual was able to survive better included indications of health, immune system efficiency, and fertility. Dr. Stephen Diane states in a Fox News article about attraction that there is a reason that sugar is sweet, a growling beast is feared, and that we all covet beauty. Beauty, perhaps, the rawest form of all energies fueling evolution, is relevant and consistent throughout nature. It is a universal form of communication that boasts, "I am healthy, well, and have good genes." End of quote. He goes on to say that features such as a big chest or sharp jawline in men are seen as attractive for a reason. A study showed that the rank of West Point cadets and the success of CEOs in Fortune 1000 companies could be traced back to facial features exhibiting dominance and masculinity. The Huffington Post states in an article about attraction that face symmetry, differences in the spacing between facial parts, and scent are key parts when it comes to attraction. Dr. Kang Lee is cited in this article, saying that the human brain creates an average of other human faces after picking up faces from everyday affairs. The brain then determines someone's facial attraction based on how closely it resembles this average, which indicates genetic diversity and a healthier potential offspring. Even smell is an important part of attraction, according to a different Huffington Post article. Smell can indicate fertility, body symmetry, and immunity. Interestingly, it turns out that culture plays a big part in an individual's definition of attraction as well. An online United Kingdom pharmacy conducted an experiment where a picture of a male and a picture of a female were sent out to various countries. They instructed the recipients of the pictures to Photoshop the pictures towards the ideal body, face, skin color, etc. for each gender. Males from the different countries photoshopped the female pictures and females photoshopped the male pictures. As it turns out, each country had a significantly different photoshopped image. There were large variations in the photoshopped people's weight, skin color, and face structure, among other things. Even though there are differences in beauty ideals in different cultures, anthropologist Helen Fisher says that there are also some universals, including smooth skin, a symmetrical face, wide hips, and a general appearance of health and cleanliness. So why the significant variation in the photoshopped people? It's as stated in a Sociology research starter, each of us filter raw experience through a socially constructed lens and only then assign it meaning. Quite literally, reality is largely what other people say it is. And here, one of the most important cognitive representations we as individuals intuit from our milieu is a repertoire of relationship archetypes. End of quote. Put simply, many aspects in our lives, including attraction, are based off what each culture imprints on its members. Unfortunately, many advertisers see this as an opportunity able to be capitalized on, since someone who is happy with their body doesn't really go out and spend a lot of money on things such as beauty products, plastic surgery, or fancy clothing. The companies making products for these things can't make as much money. So the solution is to make the models presented in many forms of advertisements appear flawless, with almost unobtainable features to instill the idea of, buy my product, to look like this. Since as mentioned before, societal ideas penetrate our minds and influence our ideas of what is considered beautiful or ideal. These advertising tactics end up taking their toll on viewers, making them feel inadequate or having body dissatisfaction. Nevertheless, beauty is truly in the eyes of the beholder, and its definition requires many different factors to be taken into account.